Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is BestInSlot with what is going to be the final building episode of our rebuild of 1993 Jurassic Park. I know, end of a blimmin' era. Thankfully, I do have something planned for immediately after this, but hey-ho. So today we are going to work on the clever girl, Muldoon's death, raptor scene sort of thing that's going to be built over in this far corner. I've had a little bit of a think, and the first thing we're going to do, I'm just going to get rid of some of these trees. We're going to push them forward a little bit. I was thinking one thing I missed was the fence at the end of the Gallimimus scene, of course, where Tim and Lex and Grant are climbing over the big electric fence and Tim gets a little bit of a shock. So what I figured we could do is just replace this fence here with a nice big electrified one, just so it looks... Who is that? There's no dinosaur over here. There's literally no dinosaur. Like, there's one dinosaur there. Is it? Oh my god, go away. Be gone, thought. I don't even know what a thought is, I'm not gonna lie. Something to do with girls. Come on. Right, anyway, so that's the point. So that's gonna be there. I'm actually bringing that forward a little bit to give us a little bit more room. Yeah, we're gonna do just that. Let's pull that forward. Make sure we don't catch a Gallimimus in the end of it. Keep it nice and straight. Too close to dinosaur. I think there's one... This little group of galleys over here ruining pretty much everything. Let's put a couple of feeders down and try to draw them away. So yeah, we're going to finish it off today. And then the next episode of this, we're going to do like a little run through at the engine. We're going to tour the whole park. We're going to bring back the T-Rex and stuff like that. We are deleting the path because that looked stupid. People were very correct to tell me it looked stupid. But hey, you got to give things a go. You never know, folks. You never know. Let's get our galleys replenished after the T-Rex ate three of them. Because he's a bloody nerd. How are we doing? Can you guys get a move on, please? And we're going to put like a line of trees behind there, and then you're going to go poof.
Confirming asset delivery.
I don't know what poof is meant to mean, but you guys understand. It's fine. I just don't really want to capture one of my galleys in that side. There we go. Get rid of that. So, okay, it's a little bit messy, but you're not really going to see that. It doesn't really matter. Right. So... Oh, no. Oh, it's this one. Okay. My goots. One of the problems we are going to have right now is putting the raptors here. I think what we're going to have to do is just cut through this whole tree line with a fence and then hopefully put enough fence over the top of it that you don't really notice. Let's go for a light one again because we're trying to hide. I want it as subtle as humanly possible. It is going to destroy the trees, but we should be able to put some down on top of it again, so you really don't notice it. I want the raptors to run around this whole area. There we go. All right, let's grab our trees. A little bit of luck, maybe. Oh, that's the stuff. And a tree line behind the fence like that. It'd be nice to have a bit more of a gap there, like there is in the film. You know, in the film, it doesn't just go fence into trees, but... Oh my, there's so many galleys. So many galleys. At the end of the day, we are fighting a little bit of a space limit right here. So... is what it is. So this area here, this path here, is going to be our... What has no power? Oh, right, yeah, no, it doesn't matter. This path here is going to be the route that Ellie and Muldoon take on the way to the raptors. So what I was thinking, because there is actually a bunker. I've got myself a big old image. I've got the film on my PC. So let's grab ourselves a... Is it operation? No. Wait, maybe... Maybe this is a bit... I had a plan, but that is... I don't know. I was thinking it's either going to be that or it's going to be this. I think this probably looks better, doesn't it? Oh, no, I'm less convinced. I mean, the emergency bunker in the film is actually quite a big building. And what I was thinking was Ellie and Muldoon, they leave a bunker, that little bunker with Hammond and with Ian Malcolm, and they leave that bunker to get to the other bunker, the underground one where all the power stuff is. So it'd be nice to be able to use two buildings. So that said, maybe that's what we do. I like that. I think it looks pretty cool. Where's it gone? I think we can maybe cover that. I think that's pretty good. Yeah, we're going to use that. And that's going to be in a nice straight line going down there. Now, this isn't going to be perfect, but I figure we put that there. That's right, maybe a bit to the right. Yeah, no, probably about there. Okay, we'll put some trees down, it's going to be fine. And then, so this is where Ellie's running. Chuka, chuka, chuka. And then to the left over here is where Muldoon walks and gets killed by the raptor. And we'll have the other bunker that they leave from over here. Obviously, it's not quite all put together, what they should do is actually walk past the raptor hatchery, but it's in the vicinity. It could have been a lot worse, I think. Right, so we just need ourselves our security emergency shelter. That's going to sit down there. So they're going to walk forward, turn right. Chuga, chuga, chuga. I don't know why chuga, chuga, chuga. Just go with me on the chuga, 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 okay? It's got a little cheeky substation in there as well. Don't know what makes it cheeky, but something makes it cheeky. Just cover this. I kind of want to cover this left-hand side a little bit. Do I, though? I don't know if I do. Now, there is also a fence going in front. It's quite a... it doesn't look electrified. So I think we might just go for a heavy steel. I don't know. Maybe light steel. Annoyingly... Right, look at this. Right, so that's my light steel fence, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 lines. But if you look at the pattern off it here on the left, it's got like a crisscross kind of design. That crisscross kind of design is what it looks like in the film, but that's not what it looks like in game, despite having the icon that looks like that in the game, which is a shame. And it's clearly decided against it. But that's what we'll go with, because it isn't a particularly intense looking fence in the film. So that's probably about... Right, this is the entrance bunker. That's where I want them to, you know, they're running towards this bit here on the right. So, about there, I'd say, there's a fence, and it's just going to go straight into there. And again, we'll do some trees and such, and we want to make this look like it's kind of like a door. I might have to bring that in a little bit. It's just because my door, my bunker, is wider than the bunker on their bunker, just because that's how it's designed, basically. Something like that, though. And we do need to forest up this little bit over. I think having forest there is a good idea. And it'd be nice if I could get some behind it, but it's not going to work. And then, so this is the main bit she's going to walk down. Now, people have been suggesting this for a while, but I want to try this out. Let me just put some trees over here as well. What we're going to do is we're going to grab a gyrosphere. If I click on the right thing for once in my life. There we go. If we grab the gyrosphere station, I believe what we can do is use the pathing tool to make a path and then delete the gyrosphere station and it will stay. Now, the problem is I'm trying to connect two buildings together. Let's just put it there for now. The problem is the gyrosphere does kind of bend, like, instinctively when I don't really want it to. I want it to kind of be straight. It's kind of doing it. Okay, now if I delete that, does it stay? It doesn't stay. People lied to me. Somebody told me it stayed. I thought that was going to look really cool. Because it would be like a dark, muddy, beaten path, which is more like what they walk down. I don't know if this needs a path or not. Let me think. I just don't think a path is going to look right, no matter what I do. Also, that's not quite right, is it? I think that one needs to come in. That one needs... Ooh, hello. Oh, looks so much nicer like that already. Damn you, fences. Damn you to Hades. Okay, I'm going to bring that in closer. I'm going to try to tighten this up a little bit. So I want that about there. And that one... Yeah, oh, God. As close as I can get, which is bad. Nope, it's wrong. It's important, this. I think if I maybe bring the fence out just a little bit further, we'll be able to keep some of the trees. They're kind of like putting shadow over the top of it, and I think it looks really cool, and I want to keep that effect. If possible, so let's try again from more around there. Right, I want that in a straight line, like so. I mean, we'll get rid of some of the trees, but I just wanted enough to give it a shadowy effect, sort of thing. Okay, that'll do. That'll do, donkey. That'll do. And about there for that one, if they're gonna match. Which they have to, because everything must match. Okay, it's all a little bit messy in there, but I think it's come together. It's a little bit Lionel, but it's fine. Okay, we're going to kill some of the trees. Oh, perfect. Look at that. Beautiful stuff. Beautiful. Straight out of Jurassic Park. Okay, now, we don't have as much room here as I would have liked. One thing we should be doing... Did I move the galleys over? Apparently. Okay, Rexy, I'm sorry, love. I'm just gonna have to... I'm gonna give you some food, and then I'm gonna knock you out. Because I need some Velociraptors. I need two Velociraptors, in particular. Also, important inter- wait, tundra. Is that what I went with? Is that what I did? No, wasn't that a test? What did I end up going with? It wasn't the default one, was it? It was something else. Oh, that's tundra. Okay, that makes a lot of sense. Tundra. They are increasing dinosaur lifespan in the next patch for Jurassic World Evolution. So that's going to be really cool. We'll talk about that in an upcoming video. But it's going to make things like this, or my 48 species park, and all that kind of stuff so much easier. Oh my god, the difference it's going to make is extreme. Alright, we need two of these. One clever girl and one to be the distracting girl, I guess. I don't know what else you'd call it. What is this lone galley doing? Everyone else chilling up here, having the time of their lives, and you being a big old weirdo. I don't know. Did I name one of my galleys? Oh no, I named a Brachiosaurus, never mind. Okay, so. We are just going to try to use the trees to make... tell you what, we can... No, we can't do that, never mind. I was going to be clever, but I can't be clever. What? What I was thinking is we could put down a path, and then put down the trees around the path, and then delete the path, so we've got kind of a path, but it's not a path. You know what I mean? Path. But unfortunately, when you delete a path, the trees kind of just plop up around it, so we can't really do that either. So, we are going to make a path using trees, nothing but trees. Like so. I think that looks pretty cool. I think I'm going to make it a little bit tighter. I want it to feel dark and shadowy and spooky, you know? That's the path Ellie Sattler has to run down to make her way over. And can I get it even closer? It has to look like a viable path, like a viable route. Oh, that's the stuff. Look at that. Beautiful. Let me get this a little closer over here on the right. Is that pushing it too far? I think that's okay. I think there's still a clear, discernible route through, which is pretty much what I'm looking for. Oh, that's one step too far. There we go. It's really bugging me that this bit here. What can I do about that? I think if I delete the fence... Also, I have to bring the fence back in some description, but if I delete the fence and just pull it a little closer to the back end, it should work. Like there instead. Is that done? Yeah, okay. right, I just wanted more trees behind the shelter, you know? I like that a lot. Oh my god, dead dinosaur. Dead dinosaur? No! Oh, babe, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. I am going to leave it like that, though. I mean, that's still kind of perfect. I don't know how long it takes dead dinosaurs to become a problem, but for now, I think it's actually okay. So, Ellie and Muldoon, they walk out of the bunker, doodaloo, they walk past the raptors, they get over here, and they start heading this way slightly. Wait, where is that? Oh, God, it's so hard to... Is that it? Why do they look bigger all of them? That is it. Right. So they turn to the right. They look that way. And Ellie's like, we can make it if we run. And Muldoon's like, no, we can't. Why? We're being hunted. Oh my god. It's okay. Like hell it is. I think that's right. I may have got something wrong there. But I don't know. That's close enough. It's okay. So then Ellie's going to run that way. And Muldoon's going to walk here to the left. And this is where Muldoon will meet his untimely fate. Now, I don't really know what I can do here to make it Muldoony, to be honest. Probably nothing. If anyone has any ideas, feel free to let me know. He does put his hat down on a log. So we're going to make him a little log. Because why not? Oh my god, look at this. When you... When you're dealing with such small areas, the terrain tools... There's a very big lack in... The terrain tools are either... huge or huge, basically. I'd like a little smaller one and some bigger ones, actually. That's still too much, I think. We'll just keep it like that for now, I guess. Yeah, that looks okay. It looks a little bit more natural. And over here as well. Sattler runs, jumps, she swings. If you actually watch it, there's a little bit of continuity errors in that scene. The scene doesn't actually make total sense in how she and what she's jumping over and swinging under and stuff like that. But generally speaking... This makes sense. I want the fence to be... It doesn't look quite like the film, and I'm trying to figure out why. I think the fence isn't close enough to the bunker. Well, it's not far off. And there was a reason for doing it. I think it looks better. Right, we're going to bring in some water, because she does get a bit splishy splashy at one point. And that's the smallest I can do. we can kind of make it more of a... It should be more of like a line. It's close. A little bit more, a little bit more, a little bit like that. Beautiful. Maybe put a little bit more in. I quite like the look of that, where it's kind of... It's there. Oh my god, what have I done? It's there, but it's faded. You know, it's hard to... This is delicate work here. We're going to keep it like that. That looks pretty cool. And she swings over a log again, and then she kind of drops down a little bit. So what I think we might do is lower the terrain. I can't do that because of water. Bah! Seriously, water ruins everything in this game. I'm not even joking. Water ruins everything in this game. That's probably better anyway. It's not proper water, but she gets a little bit muddy. Let's put it that way. Okay. What was that notification I just got? Was it important? I feel like it might have been important. Ah, who knows? I think it's... I don't know what else I can do, to be honest, lads and lasses. That's where Muldoon goes, and then he's like, chuka chuka, splish splash, chuka chuka, chuka chuka chuka. Poof, through the doorway, into the thing. Ellie survives. For now. Well, forever, actually, as it happens. I think maybe I can bring the forest up here a little bit more. It should feel like they are a little bit further forward before Muldoon turns and says they've been hunted, and then he heads that way. And then he puts his hat down on this little log here. Okay, it's a hill, but we can pretend it's a log. I am going to say that's done. Now. No, 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 no. I would like to put a fence in to kind of keep one of the raptors... There's no way to do it. There's no way to keep a raptor precisely where I want to be without having like a really ostentatious fence. I'm just thinking, where would I put a carnivore feeder? Maybe we can put one here, right? Behind the mound. So that's where it'll be. Right, that's really cool. Right, so because the carnivore feeder's there, it's not a goat, so it will stay there, right? You can't really see it as he looks over. So pretend this mound is the log, and he's looking forward, and he sees the raptor there, and you're going to see it there, because that's where they are, because they're eating there, even though you can't actually see the feeder pretty much at all. And then he dies from the left. And he's not really going to die from the left, just because... We're not that lucky to be able to do that kind of thing in like pretty much any game in history. Never mind Jurassic World Evolution, so that's fine. Anyways, raptor time. I was meant to knock you out.
Adding to the list.
Raptors. Just need to. And then we're done, folks. Next episode, like I say, we're gonna do a big old tour off the park. We'll ship in the T-Rex. We'll try and do a T-Rex breakout as well. I am slightly tempted to hold off. I don't know how I'm gonna do the breakout. I think, again, it's going to be a case of just stick a goat here and have the T-Rex walk out, and that's going to be enough. And I'd like to see the scene again when we get a bit of rain going, when the patch comes in, whenever that may be. Hopefully before I go away, because I'm going away really soon, and I wanted to see it before I go, but whatever. Yep. And then we'll do a tour of the whole thing, and this all is going to be driving me through there, through there, through there. Where's my Dilo? It's over there. Okay, if I replace your food, you'll come back down. We haven't heard anything about infinite feeders yet, but I'm really hoping it's on Frontier's list. Drive through here, release the T-Rex over here. We can get the galleys back over there, no problem. So we'll herd them this way, have the T-Rex come out and eat a few. Go through here. I think we need a gate. We're not going to drive through. Well, we are going to drive through here because it's the only way to do it. So we're going to stick a subtle gate in on this right-hand side. And then try to drive through there, approach from here, drive down here. It's a shame we can't walk around the park. I'm hoping that's definitely something we get to do later on. And we can do an all F4, F2, not F4. We could do a tour like this as well. And that'll kind of be the same thing, but nothing will move. So I think driving through is probably the best option for now. But for now, we're just waiting on our raptors, really? Everyone seems okay? You alright, Rexy? Well, sort of, but not really. I was really confused for a second. Why do I have two T-Rexes? Of course I have two T-Rexes. Hope dope.
Adding task.
Okay, I'm gonna name one of them Clever Girl. In preparation. Because that's what she is. Aren't you, love? See, she even juked the dart. Despite not moving at all. Despite my helicopters having incredibly increased accuracy. It doesn't matter. Oh, finally. Okay, I now have a drowned Velociraptor, which is nice. Let's get them moved over into this paddock over here.
Collecting asset.
Collecting asset. Not really that dramatic, is it? Come on, last one. Pachoom! Pachoom! There we go. Right. So just for this bit, let's just stick them both over there. They'll probably... I'm going to move one over here because I want... I just want to see one raptor. I just want to see that one that he looks at from a distance. You know, the one that just sort of... He's prepping his shotgun, which looks like a spaz to me. And he's just eyeing up that raptor in the distance as the other one slinks around him, ready to attack. Very cool. No, just waiting for that. They're on the way. Do-do-do-do, I was hoping to catch it. Wait. Do-do-do-do, God damn it. Maybe. You look lovely. Okay. So we, till then, will be Muldoon and Sattler. La-di-da-di-da. I'm Sattler. I'm Muldoon. Do you believe it? Is it good? I think it's pretty good. La-da-da-da-da. Oh no! Raptors have broken out. Whatever shall we do? We shall keep walking forward, severely underarmed for the situation, into the deep dark forest. Only one of us has a gun. I don't know why Sattler doesn't have a gun, but she doesn't have a gun. Hurry up, Raptor. Can't do anything with the smoke here. I'm trying to roleplay. Love how that's... It'd be nice if you could do this like permanently somehow, so you could have like a foggy... You'd hide it in some bushes and stuff like that, hide it in the tall trees, and have this permanent fog and smoke coming up, and you could do like a Jurassic Park 3 kind of thing. I think that'd be pretty cool. Maybe we should do a Jurassic Park 3 kind of thing.
Asset transportation complete.
Okay. Do 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 do. Raptor. Pretend you don't see anything yet. Do 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 do. Okay. Can't see the raptor. Never mind that it's over there. Turn to the right. So that was like... Well, we can make it. No, we can't. We're being hunted. Blah, blah, blah. Whole thing I did before. Sattler's going to end up jump over a log. Poof, splish, splash, water. Chuka, 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 chuka. Ba-doomf. Into the darkness. But Muldoon is heading over here. He walks forward. He stares into the eyes of the raptor. You can just about see in the distance. And then blammo! I think these raptors are... I don't know, I think it's because we're like, the camera is not human height, all the dinosaurs intrinsically feel a little bit small in a way, but I mean, it is, I feel like the base scale of the game is just a little bit weird somehow, I can't really explain it. There it is. So he's watching it, let's get a good look at our raptor for the thumbnail as well. There she is, that's the clever, well, she's not the clever girl, the other one's the clever girl technically, but... Not that you're not clever, love. You were a big part of it. I needed to turn around. Maybe we needed to be closer. I'm going to move him a little closer. So where's the hill? Where's my mound? There's my mound. Wait, no, where's my mound? This is really obnoxiously hard to do sometimes. Right, there's my mound. I'm going to put it there. Because you can still barely see it. Trees! Okay, she's there. Let's hide behind the tree, the meat, a little bit. Muldoon's watching, gun cocked. You see what I mean by the scale? I don't know. She looks tiny. Because everything's huge. You know what I mean? It's weird. So she's not the clever girl, but they're going to roam around and there's not really much I can do about that. There's the other one, who should be off in that direction. She's in there somewhere. I'm not allowed in there. See that? I can go in like this. Can I even do... Oh, I can't even do that. I didn't realise. Huh. They really... The dense trees are super blocked out to humans. She's in there somewhere, though. She's in that. She should start heading towards the food. There she is. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to end it there. If you have any suggestions how you think this could be improved, feel free to let me know. But I'm pretty happy calling this whole blooming thing finished. And we're going to do like a really cool tour next episode. Like I say, I'm going to probably shoot one of the Brachiosauruses and move it up here as well, just to kind of get that part of it. There is going to be a bit of an angling and moving around of dinosaurs and stuff, but we'll do a little bit of a roleplay tour. We'll have a little bit of fun. We'll see the entire park in its... Oh, my phone's gone. Right, okay, I'm going to go. Thank you for joining me. Cheers, much love, as always. Bye-bye. Quick little shout out at the end. This video and others like it would not be possible at all without the support of you guys watching me at home and also everyone on this Patreon page right here who supported me in the last month. If you want to help out as well, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. Every little really helps. Cheers.